Hey everybody, PrepBoy1 here, and welcome back to my 15th Raven review. In honor of my 15th Raven review, I'm going to be taking a look at still probably my favorite prop that I own, the Spirit Halloween 2014 Witch of Stolen Souls. Without further ado, let's look at her box. Since she's from 2014, of course she has the green, old green slimy writing that reads the Witch of Stolen Souls. As you can see, she's motion activated, moving mouth and tilting body, lighting up eyes and lantern, moving hands inside the lantern, and frightening audio. There's a huge picture of her, and she retailed $200. So I refuse to get rid of her box because it just reminds me of 2014, and as some people should know, 2014 is my favorite year for Spirit Halloween. Without further ado, let's get away from her box. Take a look at the prop herself. So getting right into our 15th review, her first category is quality. Will she break easily, and is she made of good material? I apologize that it is hard to see, but as you can see, she stands on a metal X base. She stands up on two metal support poles, and here is her module. This is what makes her tilt back and forth. And then here's her speaker where the plugs plug in, and then her volume control. And then her head, which is a simple YJ connecting head. While it did seem like she was made of alright and pretty good material, she has broken on me once when her wire pulled off and she did not move side to side anymore. And since she is from 2014, of course she is rather old, and she's just very brittle, and you just have to be really careful with her. So that is, since she broke already once, and she kind of broke twice, but the one time, it just kind of fixed by itself. So I'm just going to say she broke once, where I actually had to fix it. So, unfortunately, since she broke once, and she is made of alright material, but it's very fragile, that is going to force me to give her half a star for quality. I think she's made of pretty good material, but you just need to be extremely careful around her. The next category is detail. Well, she does lack in quality toward her feet. I just wanted to show you guys her wardrobe a little bit. Her kind of velvet red wardrobe. I know it looks purple, but it actually is red. They even added some nice curves right there, and that's supposed to be there. So they added some just a little bit of wrinkles and stuff to make her wardrobe a little more realistic. Then on her lantern, we have some spider webs in pretty much every corner of the lantern all the way around, and that's pretty much on every single corner of it too. The lantern constantly stays lit, even when she's not plugged in. As you can see, she's not plugged in, and her lantern's still lit, because there's just a switch on the bottom. And then her hand, I know mine is dented, but there's just some wrinkles. She has some black fingernails. I mean, it's just kind of there to give her just a little more detail. I know she doesn't have her right hand either, because she's not supposed to. It's supposed to look like her right hand is hidden in her wardrobe. And then moving on to her face. Now, as I was saying, she doesn't have much detail on her body, but her head really makes up for it. She has so many, like, wrinkles. And she has no eyebrows either. A lot of wrinkles on her forehead to make her look really mad and just old. And then her pointed nose. And then, she has a lot of warts on her face, like there's one on her nose. She has one right here. Her sensor even kind of looks like a wart. Then she has some really pointy ears to make it look that much better. She has eyelids, which are really cool. And then her mouth, she even has a bottom lip. She does not have an upper lip, which is kind of weird. And then, they even made gums for her. They even made her lose a tooth. And then her teeth are just all uneven. They're very dirty. And then she just has some gray hair. And then, of course, her long witch hat, which is basically impossible to position, but I don't care if it's just hanging out like that. And then they even gave her some little lines. Yes, I'm still that stupid. I still don't know what those red lines are called. So if someone can just point those out, that'd be great. So as you can see, not very much detail coming around here, which her detail definitely improves in her head. And due to her head being so well detailed, that's just going to have to give her one full star for detail. Very good detail in her head. And then her lantern is actually very well detailed too. Our next category is animation. Please excuse while I go plug in the Witch of Stolen Souls, and we will be back to see what she does. Oh.
Need need a light in the dark.
She does have volume control,
too. Nothing burns brighter than a child's soul.
As you can see, as she talks, her mouth moves very well, and since her head is pretty much made out of all latex, her mouth movement is very fluid and very cool, and it looks very realistic on her as well. Then, of course, when she's done, she moves side to side, as well as her lantern features the hands that bang on the lantern to try for the kids to escape, to look like they're trying to escape her lantern. I'm going to give her one full star for animation. I feel like her animation is very well for what she does, and I don't think she can really do much else. So without a doubt, probably one full star for animation, at least on my rating scale. Our next quality is price. As I mentioned before, The Witch of Stolen Souls retails for $200. I feel like this is asking just a bit much for her. I think she would be worth more around in the 180, even 170 realm. Well, I do understand you are getting some really good detail, and she is actually a really scary prop. I still think she should be lower to 170 only because you aren't getting the best quality. I have seen many other ones broken. Like, sometimes her mouth is broken, or for example, one of her eyes are burnt out, or both of her eyes are burnt out, whatever. And sometimes her lantern doesn't even go off. So due to her being a bit older, and she's still just a bit fragile, I'm still going to give her half a star for price. I think she could have been lowered to around $170-ish. But other than that, yeah, just around 180, even 170. So half a star for price, as I mentioned earlier. Our last category, which I believe is most important, is how scary is the Witch of Stolen Souls? Anyways, our next last category is scare factor. This is probably the Witch of Stolen Souls' strongest category. I still think she remains as one of the scariest props that I own. Sure, she is just a witch, and she just basically looks like an old hag. But I love the detail on her face. It looks very realistic, and once you turn her on, the way her mouth really moves is awesome. And then the scariest part of her is, of course, I think at least, her lantern. With all the children screaming in there as they bang on the, well, glass, and they're trying to escape the realm of her lantern. I think that is the scariest part, even for children, because who. But other than that, yes. I think she is very scary, just because, just the way she looks too. They even made her, like, a little bit lopsided, just to make her look like she's not very sturdy. And yes, that is the prop. She is on level ground. And as I keep saying, her lantern's probably the scariest part. Of course, with the kids banging on it, and just the way it stays constantly lit, just makes it kind of more realistic. So, giving her that, with the lantern being probably the scariest part, with a bunch of children stuck in it as she stole their souls, I am going to give her one full star for scariness. I think she can scare so many people just by her looks, even if you don't have her, like, plugged in or activating. She will still scare a bunch of people. Taking a look back at this review, we gave Witch of Stolen Souls half a star for quality, one full star for detail, half a star for quality, one full star for detail, one full star for animation, half a star for price, and one full star for her scare factor. Giving the Witch of Stolen Souls a 4 out of 5 skulls. I think this is a very fair rating for her, because she is a very scary prop, but I think she only has a fair quality and kind of an overpriced. She is still kind of an overpriced prop, but other than that, she still remains my favorite prop that I own. She's just so scary, and she scared a lot of people in my haunt. Because a lot of people in the haunt, as soon as they saw her, they pretty much turned around and left. She's very scary. So that's why I'm going to give her 4 out of 5 skulls. Thank you guys so much for watching this review.
I fill my lamp with the light of the pure.
She does have volume control too.
Oh, so young.
Thank you guys for watching this review. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. We are 2 away from 200, so stay tuned for my 200 subscriber special. Thank you guys, and goodbye.